The flux versus time.r script is utilized to estimate dose and time-dependent responses based on the red to green fluorescent protein ratios in the vacuole. Before we run the script, however, we need to create an info.txt file, and we'll do that with Excel. It needs to be two columns. The first one is treatment, and the second one is start time. Please note that everything in this document has to match perfectly to your file. The treatment we have is vehicle, and the other treatment in this demo file is 0.5 m.azd. The start times for both of these treatments are as follows: 18:03:20. The formatting of this is very important, and if you're having trouble with Excel auto formatting, just change it to text. All right, so here is the example, and what we need to do is just go File, Save As, select the folder, and name it info. So this file will be called info, and it has to be a tab-delimited.txt file. Click Save. And now we're ready to run the R script. So back to R Studio, select R script, and pick flux versus time.r. Then go to code, source, and select the file. For this, we'll use flux versus time demo. Hit OK, and you'll be asked to enter the number of time points. For this experiment, I scanned at three different time points. So we'll enter three and hit enter. Now, if you go to the file, you'll notice that there's now a summary graph. And this shows the normalized ratios over time since inoculation, which is represented in hours. And this is normalized ratios to the vehicle. Within the file, you'll also see there's now a full summary of the data and a summary broken down per seedling. If we take a look at the full summary file in Excel, you'll see that all the data is organized neatly. The statistical test that you run will depend on your experimental designs and can be performed with R or other software such as Origin, JMP, or GraphPad by Prism.